All right, we're back. There's gonna be some background noise, unfortunately, because it's really hot, so I'm running the fan and pointing it at my face. Oh yeah, we have dramatic new world map music because the world is in danger. I like it. I thought the high wind was faster than this. Seems like it's kinda taking it easy. So this is Medeal, right? Medeal or no deal? I do like being able to be Tifa on the world map though. Do be Medeal. It's a frog? Bush. It's like a bush. Kind of a lively looking town. The world might be ending, but it's hardly our problem. Bupper. Oh, plot bearing. Waha? Bingo! I appreciate that they're in sync on their reactions. Hey! Music cut out. It's very, very good. Party members are not welcome. Only Tifa can do this. Knowledge down. Took a bath in the planet's brain. We'll worry about him so effectively. We're back. She's quitting the planet saving. She's not a planeteer. I like Kitsith's one-armed shrug. Now who will lead the party? Can I be Kitsith on the world map? Please. Let me have this. Oh, Baron is the new party leader. We're just cycling through everybody. That's old news, man. Ooh, the reverse spy technique. Huge materia. It's back. How about it? What can you use it? Does materia explode? Ramming speed. You say. The materia power. Seems like the translation had a rough time of it here. How do we get the huge materia sans cloud? Barrett's Cloud's a number one secret fan. Put Red 13 in charge. Make Kitsith the new party leader. Really do have just the revolving door of party leads, I guess. But I never noticed that Cid has a special run. It's so good. Alright, Teffy. Oh, having a bad time of it. Respectable. respect their captain. So it's surprisingly not that far behind in levels compared to some of the other characters. I wonder why. Double interior, interesting. Hard to say no to. Mighty hard to turn down. Why is the fire emblem so good? What is going on? All the elemental armlets are really good. What's my restore looking? Good. Bio's gonna get leveled soon. Good stuff. Do I have any max level fires? Of course not. Or level 3 fires? I gotta have it on somebody, right? No, even her fire's only level 2. Hmm. Weird. Anything else? I feel like not really. Oh yeah, I've got the new cover because I matched with the old cover. Like leaned back around just gets me. It's a man more comfortable in a pilot's chair than running around on the battlefield. There's one at Gengaga, right? But let's go to Coral first, I guess. Get that out of the way. First things first. It's somewhere right up here. It's like the cave with some special material in it or something. You gotta use all the powered up chocobos for. This is Nibelheim. Coral. Coral's done by, yeah, the big desert. Sid's on the world map. Tifa really did not get a lot of time at the helm. Just enough time to figure out that Cloud's a deal. At some point we go through, what do you call it, Terry? We go back to Rocket Town, I think. Just says, enough. It didn't, juice up the enemies, that looks like. Still on some basic stuff. Which is kind of surprising. But it is kind of a nice, like, what do you call it? Do I have ice anywhere? Probably Tifa has it or something weird. Oh yeah, it's like a nice, you know, how far you've come kind of progression thing. Why is Yuffie just getting wrecked by these things. What did she do to them? Got like 10 XP. Let's go. The camera is kind of losing it at this angle. I guess I probably could have parked somewhere smarter. Oh, by Costa del Sol, that's where the other side of the wall is. I guess it's a little bit awkward, kind of, no matter how you slice it, though. I think the reactor is sort of in the middle. Because I thought I had to go through some lead up to it, kind of either direction. Should have done this straight away. What other enemy skills are even left? I feel like I've got so many. I'm surprised at how good so many of them are, though. There's a lot of good AoE spells tucked away in there, and then it's pretty good utility as well. Things like Big Guard and White Wind. I haven't really used White Wind that much, though. Probably should use it more. Kit Sith does have just an absurd amount of HP. I was gonna say, I can't jump across these, right? Nice. And there's like the weird skydiving minigame or whatever that happened here too. I don't remember where that spat me out. I think a lot of the huge material are pretty... It's like a pretty chill quest sequence from what I remember. Just sort of vibing and like revisiting a bunch of old locations. Getting ready to... basically do side quests to, you know, level up, get ready to end the game. It's kind of the pre-end game activities. All this to say, I don't know if I really need to save here, because I don't think there's like tough bosses or anything. Like, I don't remember any of the bosses surrounding huge materia, or even if there are any. I feel like we just roll up and are like, one huge materia, please. That's kind of it. Back. The young counterattack. Oh yeah, I've got the 100% cover plus counter. Some strong stuff. It's either an AoE attack or it gets intercepted by this gigantic wall of Kit Sith. The all materials are coming along. Good on them. These guys just like, hey, stop that. I do like Sid as an additional level of just goofy charm with this party. I guess he does sort of function similar to Cloud in terms of being a kind of the earnest character compared to Kid Sith and Yuffie being just goofballs. I feel like I can see the difference between Sid being kind of lighter on materia and Yuffie being extremely heavy on materia. Oh yeah, the train happened. Classic train tracks leading to the Baker Reactor. Just as you would expect. I should have brought Barret. I'm freaking doofus. It's like tailor-made for this. Huge materia? We need our own train that can fly. train chase. Remember, is there a way to save Coral? I feel like you might just end up getting it ran by a train, kind of, no matter what. A regular attack just too much damage. Whoops. Yuppie is probably the opposite. Oh wait, did I miss the third critter? Or doll or whatever the frick is. Oh, so I guess there's just like an enemy on each train car. Just summon. Oh, but it's gonna take forever. I should not summon. I should refrain from summoning. The time tax is too real. Oh, Comet is still pretty good though. Alright. Summoning may not be required. Oh, the silence on top is kinda rough. There's like a little mini boss at the end of this. Oh, we got new giants. Just don't want the enemy skill. This one. Oh, the action queuing system is working like a charm. Not interceptable by by cover. Let's get it out. It's very useful information to possess. Oh, a big garden joyer. See you out there. I think this is true damage though. Up in a hurry. That thing is no joke though. It's a large lad. Ooh, a flying thing. Using both wings. They've thought of everything. Dropping rocks on them. And I guess Acme waits. She gets 30 MP back. Another one. I guess. I thought I'd just cure between fights. But if this doesn't go off. Oh well. I guess I didn't have to worry about it. Boink. Maybe this is the last one. Oh yeah. Stop it. You guys. Just some dude. Behold, my HP. Weaponized HP. Easy peasy. Can drive anything. Up in menu, right? Oh. Just kinda send it no matter what. Can you mess that up? I feel like you can. I feel like I've seen the town just get bonked. Oh, I do feel like such a schmuck for not having Barret here. Oh. Well then. It's normally 50 kill. But I guess it's the thought that counts. It's a gesture of appreciation. That goes far. Give it to my wizard. Begone steel. It's Ultima time. Oh, interesting. It starts out without Ultima even, like, available. You have to earn Ultima. That's actually kind of neat. It's a fun way to use their, what do you call it? The material leveling system. Dude's mad. I guess I am glad that I parked here because that's where we ended up, so. If I'd parked at the other end, I would have had to, like, if it parked over here. Oh, it is just right here, right? Because that's like the cave to Coral. Wait, what is that place? I legit can't remember. But I can find out. Did we do all the huge materia without Cloud? That seems like incorrect. Oh yeah, so this is the other entrance to Coral. I thought it was connected to Costa del Sol, though, right? If there's Costa del Sol, and then you like cruise up this way. Oh yeah, and then you take that little like weird road thing through the mountains, and then there's North Coral. Okay, that makes sense. And then I saw Rocket Town over here, right? Which I think has something going on in huge materia news. Maybe just have to go to Gungaga and what do you call it? I guess that's life. Damn. I was hoping that I'd get like cool dialogue for having Sid in my party. I wonder if I go visit Oh, I forget the girl's name. Do you? No. He doesn't know. Jury's still out. Shara, that's her name. I kept thinking Marlene, but I was like, I know that's Bear's kid. Like that we start out by stealing a small plane and then steal a much bigger plane. It's the kind of character progression that I can get behind. Alright, so I guess it is for Condor time. And then yeah, I think one's in Gungaga, and then they said they already got one from somewhere else. Yeah, we can go to Fort Condor first. Since that's what they're pushing us towards. Simpler time. Back when that was real damage. We only had a couple hundred HP to our name. Look at us now. I thought we got Claude back faster though. Maybe it's after all the huge materia. I had it flipped though. I thought like we lost him, like we didn't even know that he was in the live stream for a long time, and then once we found him, we got him back pretty quickly, but it seems like it's the opposite. You find out that he's in Medeal pretty soon. Sentiment. Not sure what they mean. What did they mean by this? Dang, no pressure. Base defense. I felt like I learned a lot from the last fight, and now I can't remember any of it. I think mostly what I learned was just swarm stuff. Wait, no, I am ready. think you only get Phoenix if you've done like everything. Like all the encounters. So I might just be like out of luck on that basis. Oh yeah, and repairers were also really good. So I can only place things like down to here. Can I put stuff over here? Yeah. Probably don't need to. Yeah, I think it was like just having a balanced comp in general helped a bunch. Because even if it's like not an enemy that they're extremely good against, I feel like still having shooters that can just like add damage to a fight helps a lot. What else do we have left? It's B3 and B1, I don't remember why it says that. That workers are that good, and none of the stone attacks really wowed me that much either, to be honest. I don't know what my limits are. Let's see, so I've got a bunch of shooters, which is good. I just need more fighters and defenders, to be honest. No real ideas onto the enemy composition. Oh, I think that's it. Alright, that should be good. Remember how to set speed. Okay. Or how to set speed. It's gonna be a learning experience again. Shaking off some rust here. Speed up. Beasts. I just do against beasts. The shooters are good against flyers. I think attackers are good against beasts. And then defenders are good against berserkers. Or barbarians, I think. Wyverns, barbarians, and beasts, I guess, is the main mix. Yeah, I think I want. What do you call it? Oh, they're all converging over here, I guess. Okay. Be a little light on attackers, to be honest. We'll see. Shooters there. Taking a detour. Not having that. Hard to micromanage all these enemies at the same time, unfortunately. Oh, it might be too late to pull this guy back, unfortunately. Yeah. When all the enemies kind of clump up together like this, it feels like it's kind of tough to deal with all of them together. But I guess that's kind of the best tactic for your team as well. So it makes sense that the enemies would kind of avail themselves of it, which is just like, pile everybody together and call it good there. So many hats. Now we can bust the flank open without losing ours. Get him. Support over on this side. Get everybody over here in a timely fashion. That'll take a long time to resolve, so got high hopes in that regard. this guy to hit that guy. This side's in trouble. Probably gotta fall back up top. Gonna start becoming unfortunate. Got one left. Oh, pathfinding is leaving a bit to be desired. The defender's gonna have to really make a run for it here. It's gonna be an unfortunate melee, I think. Yeah, we lost numbers. Wolf, they just keep coming. This is probably gonna end up being a repeated final showdowns at the, what do you call it? Stops it. I ran out of fighters in a hurry. Which probably means we're trying to get done though. cause too many. Dang, that is a lot of enemies. You gotta be extremely efficient. I guess this is where you probably need the static defense to really hold up. Dang, it feels like even with that though, this is asking a lot. With good matchups. Maybe you need to be more aggressive and like take enemies on when they're in small groups or something. So yeah, now it's just like a couple of tanks. And a shooter against the world. It's probably not gonna go right. Make him bleed for it. That's about a. Giving it the old college try, but I don't think it's gonna happen, unfortunately. And we're gonna be pretty deep underwater, but. The boss hasn't even shown up this whole time. That's wild. I think we might actually lose if they tag the. Too many times, so it might just be a lost cause, kind of no matter what, unfortunately. But we'll see. It certainly was not very clear how things were gonna operate, so it's anyone's game. Hopefully, we can't just take the other. Though, yeah, it's stuff like. Or Coral and stuff, you might be able to lose, or at least do worse. Maybe that's part of it, is like, maybe you can't get Phoenix if the reactor gets damaged. No, so they got the Nibelheim speech material, that's what it was. But there are others waiting. Everybody's supposed to die. I accept this. What brand is this? Not very. Yeah, so if you just have to deal with that like 10 times or something, it's annoying, but not the end of the world. Materia. It's huge. Do these all get cool little cutscenes? It's Phoenix. Oh, we do get Phoenix. That's no condor. That is a very cute bird model, though. They gotta change all their signage now. Fort Condor no more. Fort Phoenix has been born. Maybe we didn't get the huge materia. So we get it from him. found this huge materia. Yep, he's got the priorities. Little fella. Yeah, these huge materia side quests always feel kind of weird. They're just like very kind of cursory. Not bad, like I enjoy the chance to like visit other places or like revisit places and kind of see other sides of the world and stuff like that, but I don't know. Just has a kind of weird feeling to them. They just feel sort of short. The condor's gone. Abdeel's this way. Medeal. There's just too many easy jokes to make about Medeal, to be honest. Almost enough to deter me from making them, but not quite. So it's been holding up pretty well as a cloud replacement, though. I want to go check Gungaga, too. Right, I should check the rest of the rest of the town out. Kind of went straight for... like a travel agency? No. Item shop, but the proprietor who tells root jokes. Respect, to be honest. Aethers and remedies. That's pretty handy. I like this person just in like permanent fast forward mode. Then this looks like their low-key counterpart out here. I didn't realize that the live stream had caused trouble in the past. Seems like it could be easy Shinra propaganda. Wow, they just got this plan in all the rooms. I want to make sure that everybody knows cash is okay. There's gotta be strength plus and stuff out there, right? What's this person all about? It's the same person. The hoarding knows no limits. Apocalypse would really make you think that material possessions are not the be-all and end-all, but this person seems to have looked at that and taken the exact opposite takeaway, so there you go. The love and courage storm. How about it? Oh wow, this stuff is pretty serious business. Defense. Oh, I'm out of money. No. Probably start picking these up soon. I feel like just going full double growth weapons has been super greedy this whole game, but I'm glad that I can express myself this way. I am fundamentally a greedy person. That's to the door in the materia shop. Malarkey. I'm not trying to talk to you, man. I'm trying to talk to his dog or cat. Probably a cat. Looks like it's supposed to be like a calico. Shop. Oh, the luck build. Lots of good options in here, too. Nothing I need particularly pressingly, though. This town is legit all shops, which is surprising given that it seems like it's out in the middle of nowhere and difficult to access. Was it the. Maybe it was the weapon store that had the door. Oh, it was. Side quest. I feel like Sid's a straightforward kind of guy. It's a lot to take in. Less and less became clear over time. What does this do? Oh, I wonder if it like, puts a death mark on you or something like that. Anyway, I should probably save before I go talk to Cloud again. Because I think this might be when it pulls through. But yeah, I'm gonna take a break first. All right. Let's presumably watch some cutscenes. And it cooled off enough that I decided to point my fan away from me. Now, who actually lives down here? Just a man with an elixir. I feel like Sid's kind of straightforward in that way. You just own it. He's like, yeah, what about it? Dedicated to living. Always been tenacious. Dang. The gear shift into. Dang, you look crap, old man. Exactly the luxury that we possess, if you haven't noticed. There is a looming apocalypse going on. Just in my like ready slash balancing pose, so I thought I was stuck. Oh. This is plenty cool. It's nothing. Everything's fine out here. Oh, it's a weapon. Just cruising. I don't know that I've had a weapon. This is Ultima, right? Oh, I should have been using. I'm a fool. Probably big guard too. Just do a casual couple thousand. I thought it did multiple hits on single target. I must be thinking of Meteor Rain, I think, is the one that will like multi-hit if it's single target. Because it's technically like a bunch of attacks against random enemies, but if you're only fighting one enemy, then, you know, that's that. Ultima Beamu! Boosted. Jump, white boy. Dang, that actually did a grip. For level 1 limit break? Respect. Oh. Oh no, it's doing something. Oh, it's leaving. Good talk. And don't come back, you hear? Oh, hey. That works. That definitely works. Sid, I'm not done with you. Don't you walk away from me. Oh, my, my mic might be a little bit close. Hang on a sec. Just noticed that while I was talking loudly, things were getting a little peaky. Just a normal surging live stream, I guess. Damn, Yuffie just jinxed it. Now that you mention it. Oh yeah, everyone's fuzzy. It's time to go for a swim. Again. I actually really like how the character models look in these cutscenes. The like, not fully pre-rendered, but I'll like probably pre-baked somehow. I wonder like what the difference is between those and the pre-rendered ones. I mean, obviously it's probably a lot cheaper to just use the same existing models rather than going for like the nice high fidelity looking models. But they're in the drink. Tifa, you doing okay? Oh yeah, the mini clouds. I do kind of remember this part. Oh yeah, the giant writhing cloud, yes. It's all coming together. Cloud actually was during the one. That's a cool transition. Phasing into existence. But they weren't alone. It ain't me. Unless... what's going on with Cloud's head? Oh, I think it's just a weird angle for his hair spike. Gonna have a seat. It ain't me. Rise. I like the way that they match or mismatch Tifa and the child Tifa. Core memory. Thank you. just a sad lad. Young Cloud. Got multiple clouds. Simultaneous. Concurrent clouds. It's gotta be Tifa's room, right? Or her house, anyway. I can't get to her room because it's on the second floor. Like, what is this cutscene? That's such a cool effect. I wonder, since it's 3D, like, rendered background, if they could just get that, not like for free, but... Oh, it was her room. Oh, he's remembering himself being in her room. Oh no. He was the reject. I was cool and mature. So I processed that trauma by getting subjected to corporate experiments and trying to become a super soldier, and failing. the kids are slowly chickening out. Not Cloud. He's determined. Claude's folks. His dad, I guess? Wow. Ah, the true beginning of the angst arc. Nah, we're getting somewhere. Sephiroth's out here projecting. I was made 5 years ago. You were made 5 years ago. Maybe it just means figuratively. You're created 5 years ago. You as you are now. He would take some kind of sneaky back road technicality like that. Well, I didn't mean that your body was created. Even though he was explicitly like, your memories are all fake. Nothing that you know is true. Everything's a lie. Maybe he was just trying to inflict Cloud with despair. It's all coming together. Not Nibble is just a bad place for Tifa. Nothing good happens to her there. She falls, she gets into a coma, she goes after Sephiroth, she gets chomped. It's not Cloud. That's not Cloud. I thought Zack died later. Maybe he escaped after this. I was just a goon all along. Stormtrooper who's ascended into main character status. Thank you. Yep, that's me. I bet you're wondering how I got here. Quick, disguise myself. I just want a big, like, cartoon arrow pointing at him. Bingo. I guess I can have the cursor do it. Bang. Genova head. It's a weird strut walk. Bro, I'm just a grunt. How am I gonna do that? Oh yeah, I forgot about that scene where he lifts Cloud up on his sword. Too proud to let go of a sword. Heated the reactor. Clouds unite. By our powers combined. I like that they all build around the little young Cloud though. He was talking to Tifa the whole time. It's like the main guide, I guess. It's also a really cool effect. Scale him down. It's a little high in the alpha. There we go. Opacity has been cranked. Yeah, that should have been maybe like a long time to see. Thank you. someone decide to stop being the live stream. Just like that. Take me away. Oh, it really is like a stream. Parrot's like, yes, I understand. Doesn't understand anything. Oh, so his body, like, got convinced by his story. Great vote of confidence. Train has no brakes because it is actually an airship. The team is back together. It's happening. I probably need to yoink his materia back later. I guess maybe they already had the huge materia from Gunga. Must have. Listen, man, don't pressure me. This is when we get the submarine, right? Fucking relatable, Sid. Just relax. It does feel like somebody's real experience with motion sickness. I had no idea the can of worms I was opening, I guess. It does have all the materia. Concern it. Oops, dang it. Ugh, I should probably just do this on the world map rather than having to go through this dude's menu every time. I do want to talk to this guy though about, I don't know, whatever he's talking about. Oh yeah, I was getting confused. I think that this means like I can fly, like I can take over from here, but it just means I can ask how to fly the airship. But I already know how to do that. What I need is another place from which I can fly the airship. Dang, he's leveling up like crazy. This dude is learning at an unprecedented rate. Oh, Badil is a hole in the ground. It's a good thing I grabbed that elixir. It would've just gone to waste. Really, I did them a favor. Did you end up this way? Oh, there it is. Alright. I don't have to do that much. Since I didn't really weigh sit down that heavily in the first place. Oh, I didn't know I had a nun growth armlet. Somebody, I've got magic plus on Yuffie, I think, right? Hey, who's got haste? I thought I used to. Did it get stuck on Tifa or something like that? Be like lurking around with somebody else. Who would have it? Barret? Ah, that's where lightning went too. And ice. Ah, ha ha. A lot of things are making sense now. Did Tifa wind up with anything stuck on her? I don't think so, right? She probably got everything unequipped, yeah. Just like Cloud did. Alright. Got that all sorted out. Oh wait, I still need to put materia on Cloud. A beatdown machine, not give him too many materia. I guess I could probably give Kid Sith more materia. But the white megaphone makes it kind of tough. I just feel like I'm not in enough danger to, hold on. I do want to go check on Gagaga. I don't think, I mean, I'm sure that there's gonna be like Shinra Cave and Tomorrow stuff a long time ago. But I also want to go visit Dax folks. It's down this way, right? It's by Cosmo Canyon. So we have to get the rest of the huge materia from Rocket Town after we grab the ones that we can. I mean, they have proved that it's explosive, so... really... they've set themselves up so far. Thought we'd get something special now that we have figured out who's Zack was. More properly figured out who he was anyway. Oh wait, we're gonna talk to this lady about this. I know this. Just the same story. It's a familiar story. Everyone tells. We tried. Oh, maybe it's that this reactor failed to produce huge materia. And that was part of why Shinra was... not frogs, please. Oh no. Well, I guess it's just a frog. Except. A single frog. I can count it. Just the one frog. But a single frog. What is this? Oh, this is the weapons guy. I thought I looked and this was connected to Gungaga. Oh, maybe it is. It is, wow. I thought I had to take the tiny Bronco to that little weapon guy shack for some reason, but apparently it was wrong. It's good to know. I'm gonna save and then take a break and then do the Genin Reactor, I think. I don't remember what happens in the Genin Reactor, if anything. So I'll have to find out. Oops. Briefly took a detour back to the NES. I guess I can probably hear to those scenes now that I've moved into the PlayStation era of Final Fantasies. This old lady is plugged in. Look at her go. Yes. Probably a bigger fish to fry, so to speak. This is what the dolphin girl looks. Iruka-san. Oh, hey, it is. What's up? She doesn't remember us? Oh, she does. Nice. How did she know I was in the live stream? Woman's intuition of my future wife, I guess. Noted. To be fair, Cloud does seem like he's a long time from getting married, so maybe she's got time to mature. Shinra's high-tech security foiled by one guy getting paid 10 bucks as a bribe. Feels extremely on brand. I guess it's like, you know, live by the capitalism, die by the capitalism. If you're gonna underpay your employees on important secret protecting missions, you just have to accept the risk that they're gonna get bribed. Goes out to the air strip, right? Yes. He goes out to. Thank you, expository guards. Continue to randomly talk out loud about. Out of the way. This guy's gonna go far. Town is abuzz with news of the huge materia. I mean something, somewhere. But I have no idea what. Still the same old outdated weapons. Minor detail. Hello. Okay. Gotta think of the regulars. This guy's really. Ah, that was the door. I see. Just looks like a wall to me, so what do you know? I guess I think everybody's got kind of the same story going on. Way to go. I was like, you know what, I'll take it. I'm not even gonna complain at this point. Nope, now we've been spotted, we've been made. Hundred Needles, the smaller version of 1,000 Needles. Oh, it doesn't do 1,000 or 100 damage. One job. It is interesting to see what stuff randomly goes through cover or doesn't go through cover. I'm guessing things that are like classified as spells don't go through, or can't get covered. But things that are somehow classified as attacks can. Appreciate the chivalry. And I hope that your turn can just like bump him on the noggin or something. A bit dehumanized. When they turn red and fade away, that just means that they're knocked unconscious, right? Mine. No. Well. There's a lot of weird stuff going on out here, isn't it? Make me more powerful. You fools. They really have only themselves to blame. Somebody's still gotta beat it. Another one was like, I don't really remember there being a boss here per se. Just kind of a thing that ambushed. There. Nice try. Thank you. Probably be better to use this, like, cover combo with somebody. Stronger limit breaks. Although I feel like most people's limit breaks are pretty... just kind of whatever. And then it's like... Kate Sith and Vincent are the only ones who have kind of standout good or bad limit breaks. Even Kate Sith hasn't been that bad. Like, I was kind of worried that it would just be like very inconsistent or annoying, but... its floor is pretty high, and its ceiling is really high, so... seems like it's worth taking the chances. And it's just kind of fun. Deeper underground. Under further water. Take an elevator down to an elevator. To another elevator. I like vaguely remember this place. I remember it being a good grinding spot. Maybe not a good grinding spot, but a grinding spot that I used a lot. Whether it was good or not. That and Gungaga. I think Gungaga I used because you could morph enemies into stats. Like stat up items, and then you could just use that to get swole. Gang's back together, finally. Got some logo weed. A little bit large. How huge is this huge materia? So I guess we just beat all of Shinra here. Oh wait, we're going further underwater? Holy. There's simply no end to these elevators. Oh yeah, this is like the reactor proper, if that makes sense. You haven't been in a reactor before. Yeah. Really inside one. I guess we went, yeah, we went to the one at North Coral, but we didn't like go inside. Maybe this is crits. It is crits. Fire beast attack. I guess death blow is like auto crit, maybe no matter what. Or like, its base is auto crit. Oh, it's the submarine. It's two submarines. I'm sensing a minigame. It gives a lot of save points, which is nice. Appreciate. Abundant save points. I feel like I might try out some of the weapon fights. I'm like 30 odd hours in so far. I feel like I've got time to mull gag around a bit and up. Even with, I assume, hitting their weakness, just did not do much. My stealth plans involving that first guard did not work out. for many to decide you like. I guess we should start by thinning this guy out. You'd think that Shinra would have some like cool aces up their sleeves. At least the Turks. But it feels like it's just still random soldiers. Two soldiers. Yeah. I feel like I can get that one kind of consistently. Slot mastery. Slot skills. That did a lot more damage. Maybe it does scale. It does like more damage if you do it against a single target, just so it's not like a complete low roll. Yeah, they do stuff like that to kind of protect you from yourself, which is kind of nice. It's not just a total like, oh, you didn't get the thing you needed. You're out of luck. What do they even look like? Somebody's claw gaming it out. If he understands. It just looks like a regular size material to me. Submarines. Hey, speaking of the Turks. Oh, and a boss. Probably. Should have been the cool red submarine. Thanks for like a random goon. He's a very busy man. Doing this weird swingy armed robot. It's a cool looking robot actually. I like its weird back hinge. Maybe we can get all the way to Rocket Town after this. Pola Pola. Spawn's next couple turns are gonna be unbeatable. Chop him up. I have no idea how much damage this deals in total. Now with extra polygons. pretty sure it exists. I wonder if you can destroy them separately. I have to assume that's where you can hurt them separately. Drop the bomb. Oh wow, Tran's actually better. I'm assuming because it's weak to the magic or something. I guess I should probably hit the arms. Everybody goes on the merry-go-round ride. Seems like this could really screw you up if you get a bad roll. Whoa, this might be actually bad news. Yeah, dang, if you get knocked out while everybody's grabbed, you're donezo. Dang, I haven't game over in a long time. Yeah, I guess it does depend a lot on who gets grabbed. I gotta do all these again. Well, these are pretty fast fights anyway. Maybe now I can't go to Rocket Town. We'll see. I guess I could try focusing one of the arms too, but I feel like just AoEing them down feels solid overall. Watch the crane game happen. Unskippable cutscenes. The old classic. Why Kid says like phases out of existence briefly there, but it seems like a thing that's going on. Okay, I guess if I can haste up the squad with Cloud first, that would be nice. Kid said just wind everybody up. to town on the arms, I guess. Oh, I'm sure. I feel like that's probably meant to be more like as if. Translation was still young. Well, I feel like by eight or nine, it started to get kind of squared away. That was my impression. It'd be nice to put on, like, MP Turbo with it. I guess if I have to pick on anything, it'll probably just be one of the arms. Just to avoid having one person get stuck. All on their lonesome. Looks like this pretty is a house, but it needs some support. Hostages is definitely pretty interesting. A bit too tricksy. But I think now we'll probably just kind of beat it down. Thank you. baby Omni Slash. Get him. Also, baby Omni Slash. Spam through the AoE. Also, again, not having Yuffie able to AoE heal at this point is hurting a bit. Oh, weird. So I can cure one all even after I've run out of cure two alls. Speaking of cure three, I was actually just hoping that I could get it. It would be really nice to have cure three. Lo and behold. Oh yeah, we need to go on the submarine chase. The hunt for Red October. Kinda tapped out though. If he's gonna be on all auto attack duty. Big overkills. Unleash Ultima. Wait, there's another treasure chest. Hold it. Hold it right there. Almost sense winning out. Could be done. Okay, so it's actually kind of old.
Open. Open.
Hey, Ultima.
Minute.
so you can take it. We can pop back upstairs for that treasure chest real quick. Please. Oh no, it's those guys! Just dancing. I don't want any trouble. I taught them to dance! Given if they get help. Oh yeah, I brought the two like motion sick people. The person who can't fit in the chair. I'm happy to be a hostage. Sit in the seat. Mean screen on. How do we go up? Okay, it is inverted. Oh, really slow to respond. Oh, I have to hit square to go. I see. So in order for it to like receive my commands to go up or down. We got him. It's a wild like the mini games just continue to blow me out of the water in this game. I built this whole thing. They're like, yeah, why not?
Thank you.
Bays Like This, brought to you by Bays Like This. Mama said there would be bays like this. Alright, I think that's probably a good place to stop for the week. Yeah, I'll do the airport. I'm guessing because that's going to lead me to Rocket Town and everything else. And that's gonna, I think that opens up, like, the Northern Craters. And then after that, it's just going to be probably a few sessions of chasing whatever endgame seems interesting until I get bored of it. So, we'll see. Anyway, good stuff.